It's the National Football League on EA Sports, and today's Clash of Conferences is just moments away. It's the Cleveland Browns and the Atlanta Falcons, and it comes your way next on Madden Football.
First opened in 2017, there's a look at the beautiful state-of-the-art Mercedes-Benz Stadium here in Atlanta, GA. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Cleveland Browns and the Atlanta Falcons. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And, Charles, we look at a matchup like this. It's really the running backs that may take center stage here today.
And in today's football, they're still valuable, not just as runners, but guys who can catch the ball as well. It's really the number of touches that determines things these days.
Started, it's Cade York, and we are underway from Atlanta. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. The Falcons now get to stretch their wings on offense here, and a quarterback for them is a former second overall pick who spent four seasons as a starter in Tennessee, Marcus Mariota.
After losing his starting job in Tennessee and playing as a backup in Las Vegas, many wondered if Marcus Mariota would get another shot to lead a team. Atlanta gave it to him this season as a bridge from Matt Ryan to the next era. Always a good runner. Don't discount Mariota as a playmaker who can win games for the Falcons. He did take Tennessee to the playoffs in his second season and gained valuable experience in Las Vegas.
The throw right sideline here is complete. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Throwing is Mariota. And complete to Drake London. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for a first down for the Falcons.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Mariota's throw taken in by Edwards. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
Trade said Ryan Edwards from a very crowded Raiders depth chart to a much more open one in Atlanta. It's a great opportunity for the third-year man who was an excellent deep threat in limited opportunities with Las Vegas. He averaged 17 yards per catch over 45 career receptions in his first two seasons. He could more than double that career catch total in his first year with the Falcons.
A first down throw for Mariota. Gets this to Ferkser, the tight end. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. Play action now, Mariota. That's to the... And it's a fumble! And this is picked up by the Browns.
Let's face it, everybody at the start of a game has a mental image of how they expected to go, and I think that was going exactly as they scripted it offensively, moving the ball well, seemingly in control, and that fumble, that's got to be a little bit deflating, don't you think?
Yeah, foiled the whole plan there, turned the ball over. So here are the Browns under head coach Kevin Stefanski. Bringing this crew out, it's someone known for his big arm since he entered the league back in 2016, Jacoby Brissett.
Spent the early years of his career bouncing between starter and backup as needed and played well, but never had a team fully commit to him as their guy. He does retain the toolbox that made him projectable as a starter. Big, strong player with a powerful arm, deceptively mobile, and tough to tackle. The best part about his game, leadership and being a great teammate.
First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea
Slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Looking deep downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
The quarterback's working all the time on manipulating the defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just scared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. It's a gain of 10, and the Browns are going to get a first down.
It's a gain of 10, and the Browns first down.
No score after one on EA Sports. The start of the second quarter, and it's the Browns in control of the football as they've got it with a first and 10.
19, 10.
They run it again with Chubb. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Sometimes it's hard to take your eyes off this guy at the linebacker position. He can really cover some ground, and he did there to make that play.
And so much of being a good tackler is understanding and taking the right angles to a ball carrier. And that was just tremendous straight line speed there. He eliminated the angles and was able to meet his man behind the line of scrimmage.
And his top speed, according to Next Gen Stats, and even 19 miles an hour.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Not much on that one, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground. Honed in on it and stopped him. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That gain on third down, good for 28. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half.
When a drive goes this long, you have to give a lot of credit to the guys up front, those big fellas, because the offensive line is putting something together that allows them to continue to control the ball. And I know a lot of people think they get fatigued on a long drive. Actually, a lot of times the reverse happens. They actually get energized because they're controlling the ball and they're the ones dictating to the defense.
This is the tight end, Njoku. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now Brissett. Out left side here to Bryant. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and it'll be second down. To throw, it's Brissett. Touchdown, Browns! David Bell, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Browns post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. But down here, I thought they were going to hand that off. Instead, a well-designed play and the pitch and catch for the touchdown.
And I wonder who came up with it. Was it a call from the bench? Did the quarterback have a good idea and suggest it? In any event, clearly an effective play call. They saw something they liked in coverage, and they targeted it for the short yardage throw.
And the perfect way to cap their opening drive.
Yeah.
York ready, and here we go as he sends this one away. And Williams going to sit on this one. It'll be a touchback.
So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons' offense.
Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few.
He's got a man complete, and they're going to get this down inside the 20.
Well, partner, that's how you make a long drive suddenly not so long anymore. One big play, and they're already in field goal range with designs on getting more than that.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Now Mariota. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And the Browns are going to get the football back at their own 17.
And as we've seen, points have been precious so far, and they just threw something away on that snap. And look, let's face it, as we advance further into this game, that play will be on the minds of everyone who's watching it. They wonder if this is the turning point. Is this the spot where those points were given away and could cost them a ball game?
The Browns now going to take over late in this first half. And they may be content to take this 7-0 lead into the locker room. We'll see. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. There to stop him on the defensive side, Lorenzo Carter.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Brissett to throw on first. He's going to air one out. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
A very limited time left to get into field goal range before the half, and they tried to get it all on one throw right there.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making them sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. He's going to let this one go deep. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. So we come upon halftime, and it's the visiting Browns with the lead. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios and this EA Sports Halftime Report. First things first, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for the Browns. And even though they've got the lead, they're likely going over ways they can improve the running game, as they didn't find a whole lot of success in those first two quarters. Meanwhile, for the Falcons, there's a look at what they were able to do throwing the football, and they'll need to get things in gear as they trail here at the break.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. The Browns offense getting set to go to work here to start the third. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll start the third quarter on the ground with Hunt. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 42 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. The first down throw for Brissett. And this nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. A turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be. On play action, Brissett. He's going to wind up and air it out. That's caught inside the 20. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line.
I guess that answers the question of whether or not they're going to try to play conservative and protect this lead in the third quarter.
And I think this is something we're seeing more and more of in the NFL. Teams not playing to protect leads, teams playing to extend them.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Atlanta, Georgia's the spot, and glad to have you along for the ride. Third quarter action, second and 10. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. What a nice little game. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he'll be tackled about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A 1 yard pickup leads to 1st down.
And that was a big time play by the defense. They as well knew where the first down line was, and they didn't let him get anywhere near it.
Running for it, here's Chubb. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Nick Chubb, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Browns take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. You get down this deep, Charles, you hate to settle for a field goal. They roll the dice on 4th down, really just hoping to get that first. But as it turns out, they take it all the way into the end zone.
You mentioned that they took a little bit of a gamble there. Think about it this way. Most teams throw the ball in this situation in the NFL, so they really gambled with a running play, and boy, did it pay off. Pay dirt.
Extra point by York is up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. So that drive in total 8 plays. And Nick Chubb the one to finish it off as he does so with a touchdown run.
King York to kick off for the Browns.
York ready, and here we go as he sends this one away. And Williams going to sit on this one. It'll be a touchback.
So we get set to start this third quarter. Here's the Falcons offense now.
And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go 3 and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. On 2nd, here's Algier. 2 yards, good enough for a first. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play, so we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Ah!
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Mariota. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was trying to get it that time to Bryan Edwards, and that'll bring up second down.
Not sure what happened there, but he just didn't get the right read on the coverage that time. Pass wasn't where it needed to be, and that'll send them back to it.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Sacked there by Jadeveon Clowney.
Remember throughout my career, hearing defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. The sack backs him up, so now Mariota in Atlanta dealing with a third and long. They'll set up to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
Now Chubb running right. That's the corner. A.J. Terrell getting up and stopping him for a loss. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Considered a pretty good kick, just cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time the break goes against him.
Mariota sets to lead this offense. Down by two touchdowns, just over 2 minutes to go. They've yet to score all game long, but now they need to do so twice in short order to have a shot. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Zacchaeus here hauling it in. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Here's Mariota. Over the middle, caught by London. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Mariota. That's into the hands of Edwards. Touchdown, Falcons! Bryan Edwards, 41 yards! And the Falcons are finally on the board here in the fourth quarter. They get one more as the extra point's up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. This will be fielded inside the five. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Cleveland offense making their way out. They can smell victory, partner. They can see it on the horizon, but certainly we're not done yet here. Defense still has three timeouts, and obviously this is a very slim lead they're holding on to.
And let's face it, the easiest way to get this done, challenge your ground game, challenge your offensive line, your tight ends, your receivers, anyone who's going to lay down a block. Don't let there be penetration, because they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and maybe bring extra people to the ball. If you can do that, make them burn their timeouts, run out the clock, life will be good. But if you really want to gamble a little bit, a quick play action, quick throw, might be able to get it done. Just make sure it's not incomplete and stop the clock.
The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll try and wind down some clock with Chubb. And shutting him off, now open field. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Browns use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead.
I know I should keep the focus and the spotlight on the hero that just scored, but tackling's been an issue for this defense all game long. I can't set that aside. We just saw it again here. Missed tackles leads to his long touchdown run.
The York on now for the extra point. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Scoring summary, three-play drive. And Nick Chubb, the one to finish it off, as he does so with a touchdown run.
King York to kick off for the Browns.
York ready, and here we go as he sends this one away. And Williams going to sit on this one. It'll be a touchback. And now the attention on the Falcons offense. Trailing in this one now. 1:07 remaining. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance.
Let's go.
Now Mariota. That's caught by Pitts. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. To throw, Mariota. London hauls this one in. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll bring up a second and short. Mariota to throw it. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Grant Delpit. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Browns defense has a touchdown. But just add that to the list of great moments for this defense today. They've really shredded that game plan on the other side all four quarters. And, Charles, that pick six, that's kind of the cherry on top.
Yeah, and they did it, and I feel like I'm quoting a bad movie line, but they did it together, didn't they? Fed off of each other, every big play they made, every tackle, every pick, everything they've done. They continually built energy in this one, and how about them culminating with a pick six?
York now for the extra point. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And Williams going to sit on this one. It'll be a touchback. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And, Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers you would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
Yeah, absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
On third down, Mariota dancing to his left. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Mariota again, flush to his right. It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose. And this is picked up by the Browns. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. And I don't know that that fumble is going to matter a whole lot. You look at the deficit here in the fourth, it doesn't matter. The coach on the sideline still scratching his head.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing a note or two about, we're going to address this come practice next week because maybe that's the reason we're down this far. Doesn't matter at this point, but being sloppy throughout the game, not going to help them improve.
19, 10. Go.
The Browns in victory formation now as they take the knee.
Well, this was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of pressure on, but we're the type of team that can flat out handle it. They stood up with confidence and made it happen for a victory.